Grace.
Yeah?
They're calling you.
I know.
It's okay. You got this. Go on.
I'm glad you came to see me. It's been a while.
Yeah, I'm glad too.
Well, I see you haven't been at school. Did your family go on vacation?
No, actually it's been a little rough, but I think I'm finally ready to talk.
All right, let's talk about the grief. How have you been handling it?
Honestly, I knew that the grief was gonna be hard with the 5 stages and everything, but it's not just one feeling that goes away. It's just learning to live without someone who's irreplaceable.
It took a while for me to really comprehend what happened. All I could feel was myself in that car. I could hear the music blaring, and I could feel the jolt of the brake as I lunged forward to the dash. It was all so real to me, everything except the fact that she was gone.
Hey, it's me. Leave a message.
Grace, who are you talking to?
I tried to call her.
Oh, honey.
It's fine.
All right, eat your breakfast. We have to get on to school.
I'm done.
You can go.
I'd always heard about the 5 stages of grief, but the one thing I never understood was anger. How could I be angry when I was the survivor? That was until I experienced it myself.
Stop.
What?
Stop!
Honey, what?
Mom, stop the music!
Grace.
I'm sorry.
Honey, I think it's time you need to talk to
someone. I don't need to...
Yes, you do. It doesn't have to be me, but you have to talk to someone.
Mom, I said I'm fine. Just leave me alone.
Grace.
What?
I wasn't playing any music earlier.
What?
Honey, I didn't have the music on.
But...
You really need to talk to someone.
But talking to someone isn't gonna bring her back.
It'll keep you here.
Okay. I gotta go in this room.
Okay, guys, so what do we think about the Ravens so far? What do we know?
Hey.
Come on, Grace, you're my brightest. You know this.
No.
All right, then. Anybody else?
I don't think the Ravens are actually there. I think it's just a metaphor for someone they lost.
Even that's really good. Okay, and that's the bell. Okay, Grace, I need to see you. The rest of you guys are dismissed. I know that these past few months have been difficult for everyone, especially for you, considering how close you both
are. I'm fine.
Grace, your grades, they're slipping. I mean, you're here physically, but it's like you've been absent.
I know, it's just...
Look, we have a mental health counselor that wants to talk to you. She's gonna call you out of 7th period by the end of the day.
But I don't want to talk to anyone.
She's just wanting to maybe help you talk about your feelings, just to try to have somebody for you to talk to. I know you're late, so I'm gonna write you a pass to get to the next block, okay?
Before she passed, I prided myself on having no regrets. Everything that had happened was meant to be. But after, I was consumed by what I should have, could have, and would have done to prevent it.
Hey!
Hey,
I thought you weren't coming. What are you doing?
Causing problems.
Duh.
Cassie.
So what was that teacher talking to you about?
Save it. I know you were eavesdropping.
Okay, but I needed to wait and see if you needed backup. You never know.
Yeah, well, what do you think?
About you needing to talk to someone? Yeah, I mean, you've just been really different after the accident. But, Grace, it wasn't your fault.
Yeah, but I could've-
All right, class, before we begin, let's take roll. Grace, Richard, Isabel, Ethan, Frankie. Oh, that's right. Grace, can you come up here right quick?
All right, so they called you down to the counselor's office, so here's a pass for you.
Hey, girl.
Cassie, you know you're gonna fail that midterm if you keep dipping out, right, as Mr. Brown goes to call roll.
Not when I have you. You're the best note taker there is. Anyways, what are we feeling? I mean, I think it's gonna be good for you to have someone to talk to.
I don't need anyone to talk to when I have you.
Okay, I won't be around forever.
A girl can wish. So what are you?
Grace, right?
Yes, how miss?
Miss Bradley, but you can call me Miss B. Take a seat. So tell me, Grace, what's been going on?
I don't know. We were just going over the midterm questions and...
Grace, let's start with the night of the crash.
I actually told Mr. Brown I would grade some papers for him, so.
Grace, wait. Take me to the rooftop. I wanna see
the world when I stop breathing. That day, I don't know what happened. I hadn't cried since the hospital, since I found out that my best friend was gone forever. I couldn't let myself be sad, not when I was still around. I was still here. I was the lucky one.
Grace?
Sorry, I zoned out.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Why does everyone keep asking me that?
I mean, you haven't been here for a couple weeks. Everybody's really worried about you.
I don't know. I think I'm gonna go see the counselor again today.
That's good. Do you want me to go with you?
Please.
And that's when I came in here. What I'm trying to say is, I think I'm ready to move on.
That's great, Grace.
Grief is like a crumbled up piece of paper. The paper will never be the way it was before. All you can do is to straighten it out the best you can. And in order to move on, I had to accept that my best friend was gone. But no matter what, Cassie will always be a part of me.